I like memes. I mean, I like mem. Wait, what's this video about? Oh, mem.ai is an app. Oh.
Mem.ai is a note-taking application with templates, and it's really nice because it's kind of similar to a lot of these other apps. You know, you got things like AkiFlow and whatnot, but this is sort of a note-taking app spin on something like that. I mean, there is obviously things like Notion, which is a note-taking app with a spin on project and task management. They actually just came out with an iOS beta for their mobile app, which is interesting. And I just love the fact that all the different notes in this are called mems. I mean, that's just amazing as a former meme lord. There's a very sleek design to this. And as you can see, there are two different themes in here. There's Amaranth, which looks like this, or Frost, which looks like that. Just a basic view of the features. If you press Control Shift Space, you get to search anything on here, which is really nice. And you can also do the same thing by opening up Spotlight with Control K. So what you can do here is you can search anything. So obviously I don't have many things on here as it's new, but welcome to mem would open up this mem that was given to me. But say I made something over here, like a to-do list, Dimitri's tasks, and then I went back to the timeline over here and pressed Dimitri's tasks, then it would get me right to that mem. So if we look at the inbox functionality here, it's similar to other things, but I actually have an option here to clear inbox, which I really like. This will remove all mems from your inbox and cannot be undone. Mems you created or have viewed before can be found in your timeline. Mems shared with you that have not been viewed before can be found through search. So I could just clear my inbox here, which is really nice, and it sets me right to inbox zero if I'm done with everything. And then when we go back, so basically how this app works is that it has a timeline regarding all the different mems that you've made over time, and it lets you cycle through that timeline as a way to view the different mems that you've had. Now, if we go into tasks here, this is nice that it's very simple but effective. So if I go and see on the top here, you can see there's a lot of nice navigation stuff. So in order to do anything in an app, it's nice to have keyboard shortcuts. And on the bottom right, if you press this help button and press keyboard shortcuts, you can actually see that there are a litany of new ones here. So if I press something like Control N and I go and make a new mem, you can see within a mem, if I were to put bracket, bracket, space, this is a task. And if I want to link it to another mem, I can press plus and then Dimitri's task that links to that other page that I had here. So then if we go back to the task list, you can see because I did the bracket, bracket, it takes any of the tasks from my various mems and goes into this task list. Then if we go back to the timeline, we can see that it shows in order what I just did, right? So if I go further with this and say, okay, let's do a template for a recipe, ingredients, instructions. Now, this is a nice recipe template, but if for some reason I end up doing something like saying I want to, the source is then I press plus Dimitri's tasks again, I can connect between these two. You can see there's actually a side-by-side view, which is something that a lot of apps don't have. You don't have stuff like this in Notion. And then you can swap between the two views. You can expand on one to go into one. And then on the right here, you can see that the mems interconnect on this side view. So if I get out of this, I can have it not have that side view, or I can have it do that. And then it basically, it's almost like a table of contents that connects everything together. So if I go back here, it just keeps interconnecting with everything else. Then if I go previous, you can see that it even does like the navigation throughout all the things that are connected to it as well. So the interconnectivity of mem is something that's really nice. It's really snappy and easy to use. And then something that I really enjoy about this app is that there are flows. So flows are kind of like automations, and there are a couple different ways to view this. So inflows and outflows are integrations, and then workflows are templates, and scheduled mems are basically recurring tasks. So if I configure something like this, I could make a daily mem. So I could do like a recurring sort of to-do list, where I could put something basic like writing out today's date really quick, having the task schedule, and then scheduling the mem for whatever days of the week. I could do Monday through Friday. And then that way I could have a daily agenda that just recurs and keeps making. As you can see, this is more of a note app than anything, as this would just keep making a page. So I could save this scheduled mem so that every single day I have a recurring piece of notes that just would be my daily agenda. So if we go back to the flows again, you can see in the template section, there's a nice little view of how these different templates work. You make different templates. So for example, if I wanted to make a daily notes template, or daily journal template. I feel like I could put a gratitude section, do daily, I could just put a bullet here, and then I could do the daily stoic journal section. I could do some notes on work, some notes on Rise Productive, and some personal notes. So then what would happen is if I create this template, then if I press on this guy, new mem from template, then when it just break this down for me, it would just have these different sections so that I can quickly go into it and be like, I'm grateful for being able to record videos. You could do something like go in here slash image and add the attachment for the Daily Stoic Journal. And then obviously I can keep going with that. So that's how templates work. It's very similar to how in Notion you can just create a template. And then if you want to actually save a new template, you can save as a template here and then keep moving forward with that. Now that new template situation was because I was literally just hovering over whatever it was. So if I select all of these, then I would be able to make an entirely new template like that. So as you can see as well in here, there is text editing where you just basically select anything you want and then you can make things like an H1, or an H2, or you can have bulleted lists, numbered lists, checkboxes. That's a way that you can edit things. It doesn't have the similar like slash functionality that Notion has. However, you can do a lot of things with the keyboard shortcuts as referenced earlier. So then tags are very similar in the sense that you can have these be in your mem. So as you can see, it created a recipes tag for that recipe mem that we had, and then tutorials as well is something that obviously mem gave us at the beginning. So if I go back into the mems that we have, go into this timeline, what I could do here is take that template that I had, take this daily journal template, edit it, make it a little bit more fun to look at, make these all H2s, and put a little bullet here under all of them. And then at the top of everything, I can put hashtag journal, make this just a normal text. And then after this is done, if I want to make a new mem from the template, then my journal, if I did it again and made another one, see that this journaling section would have two different mems based on the tags which are in them from the hashtags. And then the last section to dive into, groups. This is basically some basic grouping options for sharing mems between different people. Like you could create groups where you can be like Rise Productive, and then people that you know, you can add members to it. Existing mems from Rise Productive will be shared with the person you add. So then basically, if you want to add these different people into the groups and then share the mems to the different groups, and you can obviously share things in mem by just going to the share button. And if it doesn't have anything on there, as you can see, it shows it's locked, so it's private only to me. But if I send it to somebody else, or I copy the link to make it a collaborative link, then it would make it be sent into the public.
If you like this video, make sure to check out this one to see how you can improve your productivity even more.